McLaren has finally taken the wraps off the F1 successor, dubbed the P1. The P1 nomenclature is a hat tip to first place, a reference to McLaren's 180 Grand Prix victories and their 46 years of Formula 1 racing. McLaren says the vehicle aims to be the best driver's car on both road and track. The design study, on display at the 2012 Paris Auto Show, lacks an interior or an engine, but the underpinnings promise to be nothing short of hyperbolic. With a rumored 600 horsepower per ton, this hypercar could easily produce over 900 horsepower when all is said and done. A closer look at the display car reveals gold foil insulating where a mid-mounted engine would sit, and a deeply sloped tail, which hides a retractable spoiler capable of extending 12 inches and acting as an air brake. Beneath the skin, a carbon fiber monocoque, unlike the 12C's carbon tub design, keeps weight to a minimum. Dual inlets at the nose route brake cooling air, while twin nostrils, a la the Ferrari F50, extract air from the nose for downforce. The P1 is capable of producing what McLaren calls the most downforce of any current road car, a staggering 1,320 pounds, achieved well below maximum speed. McLaren officials say that no more than 500 examples of the P1 will be built, and insist that this newest flagship will far eclipse the acceleration, cornering, and stopping capabilities of the F1 when it reaches production next year. While the F1's lore is impossible to dispute, the real test for the upcoming P1 will not only be whether or not it's deemed a worthy spiritual successor to its ancestor, but how it compares to impending hypercars like Ferrari's new Enzo and Porsche's 918 Spyder. One thing is certain, the renaissance for hypercars is near.